So the first organization is a stack CPU organization. It is a stack CPU organization. So what is a stack CPU organization? Let us look at it. We have the CPU, or we have the ALU unit. Assume this is representing the ALU unit. ALU. And with that ALU unit, we'll be having two things. Number one is the accumulator, and second one is the temporary register. So this is accumulator, and second one is the temporary register. Okay, and this ALU is communicating with the accumulator and the temporary register. So temporary register is actually used to store the temporary data while execution of an instruction. For example, if you have carry, or if you have auxiliary carry, or this different kinds of carry, all the data is stored in the form of temporary register. And ALU and accumulator is a memory location or register which is available with the ALU, so that whenever you perform an operation, that operands, everything that will be stored in the form in accumulator. So it is a memory location, okay, memory storage. And this complete is representing the CPU organization. And here in this case, we'll also be having a memory. So this is a memory, and this memory will be acting as a stack. So this is a stack memory. Okay, and this system, this complete case that will be communicating with a stack memory like this. This is stack CPU organization. Okay, so whenever you perform an operation, that data will be always be present in the stack memory. For example, if you want to perform an operation like add A comma B. Now A and B may be some values, and they will be stored in here. Like A and B will be stored inside the memory. A and B will be stored inside the memory. So whenever you are performing add operation, then first of all B will be popped out, then A will be popped out, then you are going to perform the operation between them, and then that data will be stored in A. But here we are not going to pass two addresses here, because this stack CPU organization is only going to have one address, that is, sorry, zero addresses, that is, it is not going to require any addresses. You'll get to know as when I finish this topic. So you can just write down the points before I explain all these things. Number one, in this organization, the ALU operations are always performed on the stack data. That is, both the operands are always required or present in the stack, and after the manipulation, the result is also placed into the stack. Okay. So the first point is, in this organization, the ALU operations are always present, present in the stack. Okay, so just give me a second. The ALU operations are always performed on a stack data, and that is, both the operands are always present in the stack, and after the operation, the manipulation result is also placed inside the stack. And after the manipulation, after the operation, the manipulation result is also placed into the stack. Like, for example, if you have A and B as two data items, so here if you perform the operation addition. Now in the addition operation, we don't need to pass the addresses of the instructions, because addresses of the operands, because both the operands are always present inside the stack. If you perform an addition operation, then this B will be popped out from the stack. That means we are going to pop the first operand, then we are going to pop the second operand, and I'm representing as pop 2 and pop 1, and then we are going to perform pop 1 plus pop 2. That means we are going to perform an operation between them, and whatever the result will be, that will be stored inside the stack. That means that will be pushed inside the stack. So it does not require any addresses, because all the operands where we want to perform operation, that will always be present in the top of the stack, and using the top of the stack we'll be able to access those operands. So you can say in the stack, insertion deletions operations are taken place at the end, which is with the help of the top of the stack. So the top of the stack becomes a default location, and stack is a part of the memory which is initialized with the stack pointer, and the stack pointer is going to point to the top of the stack. And here the compatible instruction format for the stack CPU is zero address instructions only. So you can say the compatible instruction format of the stack CPU is zero address instruction only. Okay, so for example, if you give some opcode, that is what is the operation you want to perform, whether it is addition, subtraction, multiplication, or whatever the operation is, then this opcode will tell what is the type of operation. And using this type of operation, we give this to this is an ALU operation, for example, that arithmetical logical operation. And here for this ALU operation, there's a source 1 or source 2. So source 1 will be taken by top of the stack, and source 2 will also be taken by top of the stack. Okay, sorry, and this should be destination, and destination should be the top of the stack. So that means we are going to pop B, we are going to pop A, and whatever the result will be, that will be stored inside the stack only. Okay, and then for performing this operation, first of all we'll do a pop operation, then again we'll do a pop operation. After this, then we'll do a ALU operation. For example, here the ALU operation is addition of two numbers, and then we perform the push operation. So you can say in this organization, each arithmetic operation pops the second operand and then pop the first operand and operates on them and push the result back to the stack. So you can say it like this. In this organization, each arithmetic operation pops the first operand. So pops the second operand first. Second operand, then pop the first operand, and operate on them, and then push back the result. Okay, and this organization, only the ALU operations are zero address instructions, but data transfer operations are not a zero address instruction. So only the ALU operations are zero address instructions, but data transfer is not a zero address instruction, but data transfer is not zero address, is not zero address. Okay, so let us take an example of this kind of operation, and let us see how these things are working. Assuming that we want to perform the following operation, we want to perform expression like this, A multiplied by B plus C. We want to perform this kind of operation. So first of all, to perform this operation, if this is a stack memory, you have to push A, you have to push B, and then you have to perform their multiplication, so that result will be stored inside the stack, and then you have to push C so that we can have that operation. Okay, so the instruction should be like this. Number one instruction should be push A, second instruction should be push B. When I'm saying push A and push B, that means A will be pushed inside the stack, A will be pushed. Then when I'm saying push B, that means B will be pushed. And then the third instruction should be multiply. Now this multiply is not having any address, so it is a zero address instruction. That means this B will be popped out, and then this A will be popped out, and then their result will be calculated, and that result will be stored inside the stack. So stack will now be storing A plus B. Now, sorry, this is multiplication, so it is A multiplied by B. And after this, there's an instruction 4, which is push C. So we are going to push C inside the stack, and then we are going to perform addition operation. I5 instruction should be addition operation. So we are going to pop C, C will be popped out. Then we are going to pop A multiplied by B, then this A multiplied by B will be popped out, and then we are going to perform addition between these two operations, and whatever the result will be, that result will be stored again back inside the stack. So here in this case, the variables are in the memory, and you can see to perform this operation, to perform A multiplied by B plus C, we needed 5 instructions. So here pop instructions internally associate with the multiplication or the add. So it is the hardware responsibility, not the user responsibility. Okay, let me take one more example. Assuming that we have the following operations or following instructions which you need to perform. X is equal to A plus B multiplied by C plus D. Now here you can do what you have to do. You have to perform addition between A and B. You have to perform addition between C and D. Then you have to perform their multiplication. And whatever the result is, that result needs to be stored inside the variable X. So how will you do it? To perform this operation, first of all, we have to push A. So we have to push A. So A will be pushed inside the stack. Okay, assuming this is top of the stack. Then you have to push B. So B will be pushed inside the stack. Then you have to perform their addition add, then B will be popped out, A will be popped out, then you have to perform addition and again store the result inside the stack. So stack will be storing, after this stack will be storing A plus B. And then you see you also have to take care of the priorities here, because of these brackets, A plus B is having higher priority, C plus D is having higher priority, and this multiplication is having the least priority. So now you have to push C. You have to push C. C will come here. Then you have to push D. So D will come here. And then you have to add. So what will happen? D will come out. C will come out. And then you have to perform an addition operation. And whatever the result is, you have to store that result back inside the stack. So after this, the stack will be storing the data, which is C plus D. Now, because we have A plus B, because we have C plus B, all we need to do is multiply them. There is multiplication instruction. That means C plus D will be popped out. So C plus D will be here, and then A plus B will be popped out. A plus B will come here, and then you have to perform multiplication between them. And after this multiplication, the entire result will be stored inside the stack again. So stack will now be storing A plus B multiplied by C plus D. Now what you need to do is you need to store whatever the result of this instruction to the variable X. So you are going to pop them to the variable X, where this X is the destination. So to perform this particular operation, how many instructions are required? This is I1, I2, I3, I4, I5, I6, I7 and I8. So there are 8 instructions which are required. Okay. So let us take more example of this, how this stack CPU organization is working.